It's Tabloid Bullshit.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
I got that juice. New AP. She got it.
I got your juicy entertainment news for Tuesday. Shaq has had to sell his stakes in the Sacramento Kings. Back in 2013, he became a minority stakeholder in the NBA team, and when he invested $500 million, not foreseeing that his stake would explode in value to $1.8 billion. Not a bad investment. But here's the issue now. Shaq is being forced to sell his stake in the Sacramento Kings due to his latest endorsement deal with WynnBET. The NBA has very strict rules against owners and players having stake in gambling websites, which means that Shaq can no longer be a part owner of the franchise. Now, he obviously knew this when he signed the deal with WynnBET, and he's definitely not losing after seeing an increase in his investment of 250%. So it does remain to be seen when exactly he will have to sell his stake in the Sacramento Kings, although he's definitely excited to see his investment pay off. And as for WynnBET, his partnership could be massive for the company as they look to compete with other online gambling giants. He will be the brand ambassador for WynnBET, and his role, he will be given the giving them strategic advice while also promoting the gambling website services. And speaking of investment, Jay-Z is investing in Michael Rubin's Fanatics company. You know, friends can do business together when you're making that kind of money. Jay-Z's latest investment sees him pouring some big cash into his close friend and CEO Michael Rubin's Fanatics sports merchandise company. Fanatics is now valued at $18 billion after investments from Jay-Z and Roc Nation, among others. Now, the company has secured $325 million to start a new company within its current umbrella. They will focus on revenue streams outside of merchandising, and this will all be led by Michael Rubin. They're also planning to make a $3.4 billion in revenue this year, and they're looking to grow beyond their main business of selling sports apparel and collectibles. They plan to use the new capital to transform into a digital platform with multiple related businesses like ticketing and media, as well sports betting and internet gambling. Seems to be a theme here. Jay-Z and Michael Rubin are also partners in the Reform Alliance, looking to help those who are unfairly trapped in the criminal justice system. So they're trying to do some good and make some money too. Speaking of making some money, are you ready for this? Kanye's Yeezy Gap red puffer coat sold out overnight, making $7 million. The red puffer jacket that he wore at the Donda Listening event sold within minutes of going online. Now, these are pre-orders. Now, he did not drop Donda on August 6th, but he definitely dropped something because the gear made him $7 million in minutes. The puffer jacket is a Yeezy and Gap collaboration. It was pre-sold for $200 a pop online. It is now officially sold out. What's even more interesting is that the 35,000 people that purchased the $200 jacket will not receive it for another 6 months. It won't be shipped until next spring. Kanye, of course, is continuing to dominate the fashion world. As reported on Forbes, he owns 100% of Yeezy. And since 2013's release of his shoe division, he has not missed one time, selling out every time he drops a shoe. It's the power of Yeezy. And by the way, the rumor that he will be moving into another stadium to finish up the album is false, but he does have a new release date. We'll have to wait and see. August 15th. If that's going to happen. And you know, I had to throw this one down because they are definitely running the town. Jay-Z, Kanye, Kiss 96. Yeah.